And there's always cows on the track. That was the same early train. You notice the track still is not in the greatest shape. And what I used these slides for initially, I took them around to Kiwanis clubs and all kinds of different organizations to bolster the concept of the railroad. And so a lot of people didn't object. In fact, many of them wrote into the newspapers wanting to save it. Always the onlookers, of course. That's what we had in Antonito. Could not cross the 285 highway. So we brought the fire engine out and it filled us with water. Antonito provided a coal loader, a front end loader. And without them, we never would have been able to get out of there. And we had to back that engine down from lava. We had no turning facilities. There's 463 arriving. That's the equipment we initially left over at Antonito. Clarence Quinlan wanted something there so that at least Antonito could say they had something that belonged to the railroad. And that was the Antonito tank?
Yes.
You'll see why I mentioned this a little bit later here. There they are building the track in Antonito. And Ken Pruitt designed the little station there. And that was mostly built with some volunteer money and volunteers. I don't know if you know that the little station was the original one, one that's now used as an office by the commission. That was the first real train into Antonito. They met us there with a great gala, including a mariachi band.
That building still exists, doesn't it, Terry?
The which?
That building still
yeah,
exists.
Yeah, the commission uses yeah. it as an office.
Oh, okay.
That's Bob Keller. We had a lot of differences with scenic railways, and Bob Keller in particular, but I always look at it that if he wasn't here, with these backers and the money, we might not have had the railroad. Okay, Ernie, I'll let you name all these.
25th anniversary, or is this the 20th?
I think
it's the 25th.
20th, wasn't it?
1990, maybe it is.
Yeah, go ahead and name them all.
That's me on the left, and then Alan Stevens. Alan Stevenson, Virgil Bockhaus, Mavis Bockhaus, Eddie Vigil, and Terry.
We've all gotten a lot older. Station's still green in this one. This was actually during the DNRGW era. They left one of the snowplows here because they might just use it. You never know.
National
that was
Park
the
Service.
Park Service train up on Cumbrie's Pass. No, that wasn't either, is it? That is the Park Service, is it, or is it? I think it is, yeah. You're not familiar with the Park Service train? In order to promote the railroad, the National Park Service had shown some interest in it. But the Rio Grande just said, go away, don't bother me. We're not going to run any trains, period. I finally got the National Park Service. The Southwestern region was headquartered in Santa Fe. And I got the director there to write a letter to the Rio Grande requesting a trip so that they could explore it and see if they might make it into some sort of national monument or something. Well, the Rio Grande wrote back and said, never mind, we don't pay any attention to your letter. So I again went over to the Park Service. This time we wanted to go to the head of the Park Service, He said he didn't want to sign a letter unless it went through Washington. So Art White, who was the associate director, was a friend of mine. And I asked Art, well, can we figure out some way to do this? Art was in the habit of writing letters for Kowski, who was the director, and having him sign them. This was a common occurrence. Pardon? And so he wrote, White wrote some letters, wrote the letter, took it into Kowski along with a half a dozen others, didn't show him anything except the signature lines. Kowski signed the letters, we sent it up to the railroad. After that, I went and visited Ernie Porter, their general solicitor, and we got the trip.
Sounds like we are running.
We paid the whole sum of $1,000 for the trip. That's looking towards Cumbrie's Pass from Garcia Lake that's up there. That's the Park Service train again. Okay, let me put a couple more slides in here. There we go. That was a snowplow run that was done in, when was that, Ernie? Late 70s?
This would be February 1974. Rotary OM's first, steam up first operation.
There's the lake from Cumbrie's Pass. Ernie and I used to go over that old dirt road there. I don't know how many of you have ever seen it. We'd take my VW Beetle, go about 50 miles an hour through that thing, and it was a twisty, turny old road, but we made it somehow. That's one of the early passenger trains the Rio Grande run. I think that was about 62. You notice there's no cabins down there.
Yeah, good old days.
That was bringing over one of the dead engines and some of the equipment. A lot of squiggles in that track. You can see the track was in excellent condition as we advertised. An aerial you don't see very often is a cascade trestle.
You can see the old stage road behind it, below the trestle.
Looking towards the gorge. That's Osier, just about the time we bought it.
Did you take these, Terry, these aerial photos?
Yes.
Wow.
Is that the governor's special, Ernie? Is that what that was? Or is that the one we did for the press? We did one for the press, too.
This is the governor's special, October 4th, 1970. There you go.
There's the picture. Quite a few of the people are here tonight. It's surprising.